Hi, I'm Inaba, and I'm with the Citizen Engagement Lab, which is the organization that helps to incubate Presidente.org.
I just listened to your presentation here on the Basta Adopts campaign, which is very successful. I didn't know all the details, how much organization involved, how many people, and all these strategies between online and offline organizing. Can you tell me briefly about this presentation that you had today?
Yeah, so the presentation I gave today really just shows the trajectory, the overall arc of the Basta Adopts campaign, which was a campaign, a coalition campaign that was launched, led by Presidente, but really originally with 30 partner groups, immigrants' rights partner groups from all across the country. And we took on a campaign to really go after CNN and ask CNN to drop Blue Dobbs from their network. And it was a campaign that took not only online actions, you know, getting people to sign petitions and text in from their mobile phones, but it really served to educate the community about the hateful words of Blue Dobbs, and then looked to capitalize on the vulnerability that CNN had around their Latino in America special, where they were very openly marketing to the Latino audience while at the same time having Blue Dobbs on the air.
From the moment of conception of this idea up until the resignation of Blue Dobbs, the forced resignation, how long did it take?
Yeah, so the planning process was actually fairly long in this campaign. It was about 2.5 months in terms of, you know, drawing up the strategy, figuring out the partner groups, getting their buy-ins. And then once we launched the campaign ran actually just over another about 2.5 months from when we launched it to when CNN forced Blue Dobbs to resign.
Great. Now, you also mentioned that you have a next campaign, which is focusing on the 287G program. Please tell me about this.
Yeah, so the next campaign that Presidente will launch is called Basta 287G, and it will be in partnership with Endelon, which is the National Day Laborers Organizing Network, as well as the Trail of Dreams Walkers. So those are the four undocumented youth, or three undocumented youth and one other youth who walked from Miami to Washington, D.C., and we will basically be going from various counties that have 287G programs in effect to not only highlight and capture stories of citizens, or not citizens, but, you know, of community members who have been affected by 287G.
What is 287G?
Yeah, so 287G is the federal code that allows local law enforcement, provides training and federal dollars to local law enforcement to enforce immigration law. So this is what gives sheriffs like Sheriff Joe Arpaio in Maricopa County in Arizona the power to conduct raids and have traffic stops to check the immigration status. Well, what the problem is with that is that these laws these programs are put in place really to try to target criminal offenders or criminals, immigrants, undocumented immigrants for deportation. But what ends up happening is that these traffic stops end up getting people on very minor infractions. You know, somebody not driving with a license, of course, because they're undocumented, they can't get a license, or simply that their only crime is that, you know, they are undocumented. And so the majority of the people that are swept up under that program are actually hard criminals. And what we've seen is that it also just increases racial profiling among the communities.
And some people who have been incarcerated because of this program are also U.S. citizens, but because of their racial heritage are targeted.
That's right. There's been a number of cases where people have been detained for days, if not weeks, as they were even U.S. citizens. But because of these programs, they were caught up in the system.
And I know personally of this case close to Washington, D.C., of Prince William County, where this program has hurt the economy of the city of Manassas, for instance. People have left the city and sold their houses. I mean, the economy has come down. But the authorities there, mostly Republicans, they believe that this is a successful story, but they're not telling the whole story, the whole truth. So I guess your project is intended for people to tell what's happening to their lives because of this program?
Yes, that's true. I mean, we want also not only the general public to know about the 287G program and how it affects families, tears apart families, it traumatizes children, But also, you know, it also economically, as you were stating, you know, affects the communities. People don't realize that, you know, whether or not immigrants are documented or undocumented, they are part of the economic system of this country and of local communities. And if you force them to move out of these neighborhoods, often what happens is that businesses lose on profits, real estate prices drop. And so it's very important for us to try to educate people as to those effects of these types of laws.
Meanwhile, the Obama administration is pushing for the implementation of this program and also secure communities all across the United States. Will your campaign focus also on telling President Obama that he needs to change its policies towards undocumented immigrants?
Yeah, so the campaign will directly look at, again, the 287G program. We'll also be educating people around the Secure Communities program as well. But 287G, we feel like, has been around long enough, and there's enough data and information to say that it's a flawed program, that we think that it's important to really kind of raise awareness as to stopping that program.
Based on the experience of Basta, I'm sure this program, this new website will be very successful. But if people want to support this initiative, say financially or any other way, how can they contact you?
Yeah, so the organization is presente.org, and people can sign up on our website. And they can also get more information as we launch the new site, which will be called Basta287G.org.
Well, thank you so much.